Okay,
Yes, sir.
so let's start with our lecture on train and create laws. What are these laws all about? And what are their relevance to our real estate professional practice? So in order to understand these laws, no, these two particular laws, and their impact on real estate taxation, we need to go quickly on the basis, no, the political environment where these laws were passed, and these were passed during the term of the previous administration. And the economic managers of the previous administration coined the term Duterte-nomics. It was the previous administration's economic and development blueprint, which are substantially carried over by the present administration, where the previous administration of President Duterte promised a golden age of infrastructure, which includes construction of highways, subways, railways, expressways, bridges, and airports. So the blueprint was sort of one of a kind, no, in the history of the Philippines, because the previous administration wanted to expedite, no, or to make an era of golden age of infrastructure. So this visioning, no, or plans of the previous administration were expected to incur government around 8 trillion, no, in the next 5 years of his administration, and projected to contribute share in our GDP from 5.4% in 2017 to 7.4% in 2022. Tapos na rin to. We're just giving a brief background. But the pivotal question during that time, how can you pay? How can you subsidize? How can you generate around 8 trillion in taxes or revenues? Of course, in hindsight, nakita natin, these plans were significantly affected by COVID. Hindi talaga siya na fully operational because in the last two years, no, of the Duterte administration, the administration, the country suffered from the pandemic. So just quickly, what was the reason why we need to invest in infrastructure? So the reasons, they were fairly obvious. Course, to reduce transportation costs and promote trade flows and increase people's income, especially in the national capital region, our heavily congested urban center. So we have very poor investment in terms of public transport. The traffic is continually worsening. So one of the worst, no, in the entire world. So the idea was the more infrastructure, the better for the country. And just a quick background on the investment in infrastructure. The Philippines is ranked one of the lowest in the ASEAN region. So if you can see in the graph, we're competing with Indonesia. No, the biggest economy in the ASEAN region in terms of low investment in infrastructure. Of course, you have Malaysia, no, Singapore. It's a very good investment infrastructure. You have also Vietnam, Thailand, and even the Laos, no. We expect this country to be behind the Philippines, but in terms of public investment in infrastructure, as a percentage of GDP, it's overspending the Philippines. That is the basis, why although the figures would reflect up to 2013, I think the start of the administration of President Noynoy Aquino, the economists in this country are saying that the Philippines needed to spend more in infrastructure in order for the country to grow faster. So how do you, during the term of President Duterte, they were thinking of how to finance this plan to develop a golden era of infrastructure. So you have mainly three financing options. So you get it from taxes. If taxes are not sufficient, you get it from loans. Then you have the famous public-private partnerships or PPPs. In fact, I was reading an article from Forbes. It stated that loans from Japan and China, they were intended to fund part of what they call Duterte-nomics. And in fact, you read a lot of materials that China will eventually be holding the Philippines as hostage because of these debt band-aids. But the facts, the actual facts, it's not China, it's Japan. It's the biggest source of our what they call official development assistance. China is the contribution of China is way smaller compared with Japan, the actual figures. So the loan side of funding these infrastructure projects, the previous government said that only 15% will have to come from loans or what they call official development assistance from foreign governments and multilateral institutions. So as a ratio of the total funding, loans account for, I think this is the actual figure also, going actual figure between 15 to 20% of the total amount to fund infrastructure. So according to the economists, to our economists, borrowing is not bad per se, for as long as interest rates are low, the grace and repayment periods are long, and government exercises prudent debt management. So this is a difficult, especially the last one, government exercises prudent debt management. This is quite difficult, in the actual implementation. But as to incurring these loans, government has a lot of control in terms of ensuring that the interest rates are low and you have very long payment periods. So if your economy is growing fast enough, the conventional economic wisdom is the country can easily manage all these debts as long as we are growing at a rate that would be enough to pay all these obligations. That's the premise of our economic managers in getting these debts or official development assistance. So you have, as a background to our discussion on the train and create law, the projected budget of 8 trillion, they're expected to be financed through tax revenues. Now again, as we mentioned, this was interrupted because of COVID, but at the time that these laws were crafted, this was the economic environment. Pre-COVID, government was projecting that they can raise 2/3 of the projected expenditures through taxation. So if you recall, when this train law was being debated in Congress, the economic managers of the previous president, they were so intent in passing this taxation measures, but how would they make this palatable or acceptable to the people. No, they made a very good strategy on income taxation, so that the general population can swallow or accept, no, this train law in particular. So to cut the story short, train law was passed. Train law was passed. The strategy of the economic managers, they said, and they were able to deliver. The train law was expected to reduce personal and corporate income tax rates. So you have the middle, the lower classes significantly benefiting from the passage of train law. So that minimizes, no, that minimizes resistance, because who would object to the reduction or eradication of payment of personal income taxes? So to offset, no, because of this reduction in collection from personal and income taxes, there should be a significant way to recover them, no, because these are revenue losses. The recovery will be in the form of new taxes on petroleum products, no, yung mga gasolina natin, diesel, sa train law yan. Ibig sabihin, every time you go to the gasoline station, a government earns, no, per liter in terms of excise taxes. Then when you buy new cars, there's also excise tax. Train law din yan. No, train law. And if you drink a lot of soft drinks, no, sodas, tinatawag nilang sweetened beverages, train law din yan, no, per liter. Mamaya pag-usapan natin. Government is happy, no, if you're drinking a lot of these sweetened beverages, because per bottle they generate, no, certain percentage or certain amount by way of contribution to train law. Am I clear pa ba? Class, can you confirm?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, so ginagawa natin background para maintindihan natin to, ha. Bakit pinasa yung train law, binaba yung mga personal at income taxes, no? Maraming naging exempted na because of train law, but binawi din naman doon sa collection sa mga gasolina, diesel, sa mga kotse, at saka yung mga what they call unhealthy, no, ng mga beverages. Yung mga tayo, no, guilty din tayo diyan, no, mahilig sa mga soft drinks. May taxes yan, no, na excise tax na binabayaran natin sa gobyerno. So bakit? Government cannot just say na, oh, let's have this spending. No? Hindi pwede yun. Dapat merong sources of yung tinatawag na revenues. Kasi kung if we do a lot of spending without taxes, that could lead to yung tinatawag na budget deficits at saka yung mounting debt. Yeah, conventional wisdom ng mga economic managers natin, they're saying na yung mga budget deficits are not worrisome per se. No? Ang what is worrisome, yung mga persistent deficits. Kasi historically in other countries, for example sa US, no, yung panahon ng medyo recession nila, mahina economy, they have yung tinatawag na deficit spending. No, government is leading yung yung strategy, no, of spending on infrastructure to generate employment, to generate income, no. Remember during the time ni Roosevelt ata yon, yung New Deal in the US. Yung mga railway, no, roads sa America after Second World War, no, government was spending a lot, no, even the shortfall sa budget. The idea is to jumpstart the economy. Yun nga lang, if this deficits will be persistent, this could lead to what our economic managers are saying na mga interest rate hikes, no, pagkatapos hina yung private spending, then you have yung downgrades, no, sa what they call yung credit rating, and that could also fuel yung lower economic growth. Okay? With that as background, no, importante na intindihan natin yung ano to, yung basis, no, the political and economic environment which was at that time prevailing, no, before the passage of train law. Finally, hindi reformation pala to. This is tax reform. No, please correct lang, no. Not reformation. Tax reform for acceleration and inclusion law. No, that's the meaning of train. This was signed into law on the December 19, 2017 and became effective on January 1, 2018. So medyo naging acceptable, no? Medyo hindi nag-konti yung resistance because of yung ano to, increase exemption doon sa personal income tax na lesser income for corporation also. No, train law was said to allow a simpler, fairer, and much efficient tax system for the Filipinos. In general, train law aims to reduce personal income tax while imposing higher tax, no, on certain products like sweetened beverages, oil, petroleum, fuel products, coal, stocks, automobiles, and others. Dito binawi. No, and hindi mali ito, no, yung pag-impose ng higher taxes. Sabi nila, this more or less are taxes on middle, no? Middle at saka higher classes, but hindi rin, no? Because yung mga beverages natin, this crosses economic class. Saka yung, of course, the taxes, excise tax on petroleum fuel, no? This crosses also all economic classes. Then yung kwad din natin, no? one reason na pinasa yung train law is to fund yung universal access to quality tertiary education. So it was during the term of the previous administration, no, after decades of yung ano to, low funding sa state universities and colleges, ginawang libre yung tuition fees in all public universities, colleges, and technical vocational institutions. Because this policy of the government in making free public education, no, especially tertiary public education, that was really unprecedented, no, in the history of tertiary education in the country. Kasi for several years, even if you study in public universities, you still have to pay. But tinanggal yan, no? Now you can study to all public colleges saka universities, free na siya. But in exchange, government will have to shell out at least 50 billion annually. Sabi nila, they co-course din to, galing din to sa yung tax reforms via the train law. So sa by way of summary, pinasa yung train law because kailangan if finance yung public spending on infrastructure, yung build na plan ng previous administration, which was the environment, no, which the law was ano to, was the political at saka economic environment which was made a basis for the passage of the law. They were expecting, no, that almost 2/3 will come from tax revenues. Then yung loans, no, yung highly politicized na statement about loans, ang target was only for 15%. Ganun lang, no, para hindi tayo masyado baon sa utang. No, but that is the strategy because this is a massive public infrastructure spending. Pagkatapos yung public-private partnership, no, especially here in the ano to, National Capital Region saka surrounding ng mga regions, maraming PPP. No, yung mga expressways natin, gumagawa niyan public private corporations. Kasi kung government libre yan, no, wala kang toll na babayaran, pero kung dinaan sa PPP, of course we have to compensate yung private sector for spending. That is why we're paying toll fees. Okay, so let's discuss yung train law, no? Ano yung, what are the provisions relevant to real estate in particular in this tax reform for acceleration inclusion law. So for board exam purposes lang naman, you have to recall, no, yung meaning ng train law. No, the TR is already tax reform. No, yung A could be very difficult kung hindi natin na pakinggan tong mga discussions, no, or read about yung materials, acceleration, yung A. Then inclusion, no, inclusion law. So that's train law. Before the train law kasi, class, yung taxation natin, medyo kahit na mababa yung sweldo natin, we are being taxed with government. Na imagine before 2017, 2018, you're earning annual income na 10,000 and below, may 5% ka pa na tax sa gobyerno. This is annual income, no? Mostly, yung mga domestic helpers natin, they're earning more than 10,000 annually. But sa previous na taxation natin na medyo outdated, may tax pa rin na pinapataw, no? Pagkatapos yung annual income na, yung annual income, no, those people na earning 500,000 and above, ang laki ng tax na binabayaran nila, no, 32%. Tapos 13-month pay, saka ano to, yung other benefits, ang threshold is only 80,000 and below, that's the tax exemption. Pagdating sa train law, tinaasan, no, yung threshold, ginawang 250,000. So for the rank and file ng mga empleyado, malaking beneficyo sa kanila. No, because rather than paying 5 to 10% in taxes, sabi ng train law, if your income is 250,000 and below, then you don't have to pay taxes to government. Okay, so maraming nag-benefits. Ibig sabihin, you have people having higher take-home pay. No, kasi wala nang buwis eh, no, for those na sa lower classes natin. And tinaasan na rin yung threshold for the higher tax rate. No, tinaasan to 35%, but the threshold is 8 million and above. Okay, from 500,000, ginawang 8 million. Kasi 500,000, unreasonable yan, no? Na hindi naman ganun kataas yung income for one year, pagkatapos you're being taxed 32%. Ginawang train, no? Doon na sa, tinaasan na sa 8 million. So more or less, realistic to siya. No, because of yung mga economic forecast figures natin na yung 500,000 is not that much higher, is not that high na income on an annual basis. So that is yung with respect to income tax. Nandiyan yung ka natin, no, yung summary, although we're clarifying that, no, yung comparison on personal income tax before train law, saka yung ano to after, no, maliit na figure, medyo maliit na mga letters to, but we can have some clearer, no, na yung discussion. Ito yung next, no, for train law. For self-employed professionals, no, SEP tinatawag nila, if you're earning if your total earning, no, for one year is less than 3 million, so you have the option to use yung train law's new tax table na upgraded compared sa old na version, or kung if you want lesser complication with the BIR, then you're given the option of a flat tax rate of 8% on gross sales at saka receipts, no. So this applies to tinatawag nating SEP, no, or self-employed professional. Tapos maganda din dito, no, yung which is really accepted ng karamihan, yung exemption for low to middle, no, income ano to families. Kasi in-exempt na yung from income tax yung those earning 250,000 and below on an annual basis. Pagkatapos yung self-employed professionals, if your gross sales or receipts is below 500,000, you are exempt from payment of the 3% percentage tax. Okay, tandaan natin yung mga threshold figures. Then yung na-mention natin dito, yung mga soft drinks, makita nyo ba yan? Maliit, maliit per liter. No, parang kung gumagamit ng artificial sweeteners, no, which yung mga soft drink companies, they're doing per liter. No, per liter ang binabayad natin 6 pesos. So imagine niyo na lang yan. Every time na uminom kayo ng soft drinks per liter, 6 pesos niyan goes to government. No, magkano ba yung yung isang litro, no, na nabibenta, na bibili niyo sa mga convenience stores, no, department stores? Automatic yan. For example, 40 pesos na bilhin niyo or 50 pesos, 6 pesos goes to government. Now, for those yung gumagamit ng they have yung corn syrup daw, na medyo sabi nila, delikado sa katawan, tinaasan yan, no, yung excise tax for beverages from 6 pesos, 12 pesos. Okay, of course, there are exemptions na sa beverages, yung sa gatas, walang excise tax yan. Yung mga fruit na vegetable juices, walang excise tax yan. And even the coffee, no, for us na mga coffee drinkers, walang excise tax yan. The only na pinapatawan ng excise tax for beverages are those with sweeteners. Tapos yung fuels natin, no, andyan din yung mga tax rates, makita natin, but there's a summation on that, no, masyadong maliit lang to, but this is for purposes of yung compressed version ng discussion on fuels, no. So every time na, as we mentioned, every time na nagpapagasolina tayo, just imagine, no, how much billions of pesos we are giving government for purposes of principally for infrastructure. Ito yung sa soft drinks natin. Kasi before train law, no, you drink a lot of soda, no, soft drinks, walang tax. Pagdating sa train law, may tax tayo, 6 pesos per liter. No, for yung tinatawag na using caloric and non-caloric sweeteners, 6 pesos 'yon. Pero mas malaki kung yung ginagamit yung high fructose na corn syrup, 12 pesos per liter. Okay, so billions din itong na-generate ng government dito sa beverages, no? Annual taxes on beverages, malaki yung na-generate na pera. So, principally for purposes of yung spending, no, in public infrastructure. Tapos next, yung excise tax, no, sa mga sasakyan. Ito medyo smaller lang na letters, we have a summation, no, sa subsequent slides. So every time bili tayo ng mga sasakyan, no, for those of you sa real estate, nagka-commission, bili ng sasakyan, imagine certain percentage of that will be paid to government in terms of excise tax, no. For those of you na mga nanigarilyo, any smoker here? I'm sure may smoker tayo sa klase, no? So every stick niyan, every pack na binibili natin, we're paying government, no, excise tax. Tapos specifically yung tax na nakukuha natin diyan for infrastructure. Hanggang ngayon 'yan, no? Every collection dito sa train law ng mga taxes, ang purpose nito is to develop our infrastructure. Ito yung clear version, no, for yung sasakyan, yung automobile na excise tax for those vehicles 600,000 vehicles above one, mga SUVs na to, no, or principally SUVs, yung dati I'm referring, no, stand corrected, yung dati before train law took 2% lang. Sa train law, yung 600,000 below, 4% yung binabayaran. So if you see dito sa train loan na summary, no, ito yung applicable ngayon, bibili ka ng sakyan na more than 4 million. No, nasa luxury na siya. Kalahati niyan pagbabayad ka ng excise tax. So they're saying the richer you are, the more luxurious vehicle ang binibili mo, the government is happy. Kasi ang laki ng binabayaran mo in the form of excise tax. Yung karamihan sa atin, no, ang mga sakyan natin between 1 million to 4 million, 20%. No, 20% ang binabayaran natin in terms of excise tax, no. For example, if you have an SUV na worth 3 million, no, 3 million, you pay 600,000 in the form of excise tax per vehicle. Meron ba dito sa inyo na gumagamit ng more than 4 million na sasakyan in this class? Walang gustong umamin. Ibig sabihin you're paying 50%, no, in the form of excise tax, no, if you acquired your vehicle after the effectivity of train law. So hindi kasama sa train law dito yung mga electric vehicles, no? Electric vehicles, wala siyang excise tax. The idea is to encourage people to buy electric vehicles, no? Kasi obviously, electric vehicles, they're more expensive than the regular cars. So kung patawan mo pa ng excise tax yan, mas hindi siya affordable. So until now, yung mga electric vehicles, there's no excise tax. And for yung pickups, no? Exempted sa excise tax on vehicles. Okay, so especially sa provinces, mas popular yung mga pickup, walang excise tax yan. What about hybrid cars? No? Ibig sabihin yung kotse na combination ng electric, no, at saka yung mga fuel, yung carbon fuels, no, diesel or gasoline, if your car is hybrid, you will be taxed at half the rates. No, as detailed in train law. Di ba sa train law nakalagay dyan 4, 10, 20 at saka 50. If the car is hybrid, then you are charged 50% of the applicable tax rates. Then the more relevant na sa atin, no? Yung mga payment ng mga estate at saka donors taxes. Magkano under train law? Anong epekto ng train law on payment of these taxes? Okay, what are the threshold for VAT exemption? Here, but in the succeeding slides, we will have this clearer, no? On a per tax basis na discussion. So donor's tax, simulan natin donor's tax. Before, no, ang donation is subject to donor's tax of up to 15%. Pagpasa ng train law, you have yung you have gifts or net donations na 250,000 and above, ginawa na lang siyang uniform na 6%. Okay? And what is very important also, no, na for questions during the board exam, under train law, relationship is not material anymore in yung donor's tax. Kasi before train law, important yung relationship, no? Kasi if you're related, you enjoy certain exemption. Pagdating sa train law, whether or not you are related or not, you pay a fixed rate of 6%, no, of net donations 250,000 and above. Parang pareho na rin sa capital gains tax, no, yung donor tax under train law. What about estate tax? Magkano binabayaran ng estate tax? No, under train law, yung dating batas, graduated yung rate. Ibig sabihin, the higher the net estate, the higher is the tax rate, up to 20%. No, so for example, yung naiwan na net estate mo is 10 million, then before, the estate tax is I think kung more than 10 million is nasa 20% na. No? So for example, 30 million net estate mo, the only way that that can be distributed is you pay 20% of 30 million, that is 6 million. Mabigat din, no? But under train law, inalign na nila, no, with the yung capital gain sa donor stocks. Under train law, the net estate, the net estate is only liable to pay 6%. Okay, ulitin natin, no? Donor stocks 6%, estate tax is 6% under yung train law. Ito yung na-mention ko sa inyo kanina, no, yung previous tax system kasi natin graduated. No, graduated if your property if your net estate is from 200,000 and above, they are subject to 5 to 10, 20% estate tax. Under train law, as we mentioned, 6% na lang. Flat rate of 6%. Ito very important to, no? Tandaan natin to kasi these are very good materials for question during the board exam. Yung exemption under estate tax under train law, no, for properties with a net value of 5 million pesos and below, no, pagdaan ng estate tax taxation, wala nang babayaran na estate tax under train law. And the idea is for encourage the government, no, for the middle classes, middle to lower classes, no, oh, magkon na kayo, mag-avail, no, ng ganitong type of provisions because wala naman kayong babayaran, no, 5 million pesos and below. So practically significant portion ng mga subdivision projects natin, no, or even condominium na medyo hindi mga bago, they're exempted from payment of estate tax. Now, if what you're ano to, staying o ginagamit mo yung family home, ibig sabihin family home, dyan nakatira yung pamilya, may exemption pa na 10 million and below. Okay? 10 million and below. So, dati kasi under sa previous na system, yung family homes worth 1 million and below lang are exempted from estate tax. Under the train law, tinaasan nila yung exemptions, no? Ibig sabihin yung if you're staying in a condominium or subdivision na less than 10 million, no, as family home, then you're exempted from payment of estate tax. Tinanggal na rin ng train law yung dati yung mga deductions kasi sabi nila source of corruption din yan sa mga internal revenue ko natin, people, no? Kasi yung subject to review, tanggal na yung funeral expenses, wala na rin judicial expenses and medical expenses, they were removed from yung tinatawag na allowable deductions. So, ni-remove yung allowable deductions, no? Tinanggal na yung mga medical, no? Mga judicial expenses. Ang ginawa ng train law, the train law increase yung standard deduction to 5 million. Dati kasi sa previous system 1 million lang siya. Now, if you're a non-resident alien, ibig sabihin dayo ka, no, expat ka dito sa Pilipinas, you can still avail of standard deductions but only up to maximum of 500,000 pesos. Again, non-resident aliens, they can avail of standard deductions but only up to a maximum of 500,000. The rest, if you're a resident, no, or non-resident na Pilipino, you are allowed to avail of yung standard deduction of 5 million. Then documentation under estate tax, yung CPA certification, required lang yan if the estate tax returns exceed of gross value of 5 million. Okay, again, ulitin natin, yung CPA certification for estate tax settlement purposes, needed lang yan for those if the estate has a gross value of 5 million or more. Dati kasi 2 million yung threshold. Then yung filing period under estate tax natin na provision for settlement, dati kasi ginawang 6 months, ngayon 1 year. No? Tinaasan, nagdagdagan ng 1 year. Pagkatapos yung train law also, yung tinatawag na full estate tax liability must be settled within 2 years. Okay? Must be settled under within 2 years. Binigyan ng palugit. Dati kasi wala yan. So under sa train law, binigyan ng palugit no, yung mga nag-avail sa ng provisions ng train law na you're given 2 years to settle your estate tax liability. Now what about yung real estate transactions, no? Importante natin sa practice ng profession. Yung VAT, no? Value added tax. So, yung train law natin impose the following on VAT exemption provision regarding real estate transactions. So, those properties not primarily held for sale. So, in short, hindi ginagamit sa negosyo. You call that capital asset. Exempted siya, no, from payment of the value added tax. Okay, ulitin natin. The first exemption sa payment ng value added tax involving real estate transaction, those properties which are considered as capital asset, no, or those properties not primarily held for sale to customers. Or those properties not primarily held for sale, not primarily held for lease, no, in the ordinary course of trade or business. So hindi mo ginagamit sa negosyo yung rentals mo, then that is still exempt na for sa VAT. At saka yung properties utilized for socialized housing. Okay? So third group, those properties utilized for socialized housing, they are exempt from the payment of the value-added tax. Held for sale to customers or for lease in the ordinary course of trade or business, that has been used, no, for trade or business of the seller. Ibig sabihin, dyan siya nakatira. Dyan siya nakatira. Then according to the BIR, the sale thereof shall be subject to VAT, being a transaction incidental to the taxpayer's main business. Properties utilized for low-cost housing under Republic Act Number 7279 or the Urban and Development Housing Act of 1992. Itong RA Number 7279, nako, previous na mga board exam, no? If you check yung mga questions, pabalik-balik lang to. Na tanong, what is Republic Act Number 7279? Dapat makuha na natin to. This is the Urban Development Housing Act. So sinasabi dito sa train law, basta low-cost housing, walang VAT yan. Okay. Those properties for socialized housing, no, you have low-cost housing, VAT exempt. Socialized housing, VAT exempt. No? Yung value-added tax natin, malaki din yan. So, yung price per ceiling, it started with 450,000 for socialized housing. Kung ina-adjust yan, no? Ina-adjust by virtue of Republic Act 7835 at saka 8763, kahit na tinaasan yan, it's still exempt from payment of the value added tax. Then for real estate transactions, yung price, no? Price is 1,919,500. Yun yung before train law. When train law was passed, may qualification siya. Train law lowered the VAT exemption of residential lots. No, take note, residential lots, extreme law lowered yung exemption of residential lots, yung lote lang siya, to 1.5 million pesos. Okay? So, ibig sabihin lang yan, those residential lots that were previously tax exempt, ibig sabihin worth 1,500,000 1 peso to 1,909,500 pesos are now subject to VAT. Kasi nilower nga, no? Nilower from 1.9 to 1.5. Beginning January 1, 2021, residential lots will no longer be qualified for VAT exemption. Okay, so yan yung history. The latest ngayon, yung residential lots will no longer be qualified for VAT exemption. Tapos, those are lots, yung sa dwellings naman, yung mga bahay, no, may house and lots, condominiums. Pagpasa ng train law, nilower yan, yung exemption from 3,199,200 to 2.5 million. So, this means yung lahat ng mga bahay, mga condos that were previously tax exempt or worth 2.5 million 1 peso to 3,199,200 are now subject to VAT. So, ito yung mga changes, no, under sa train law effective January 1, 2021, yung exemption nilower. Nilower, di ba, dito sa atin, simula sa 3,199,200. Take effect na ng ano to ng train law, nilower to 2.5 million. By effective January 1, 2021, nilower pa yan yung exemption from 2.5 million to 2 million. So under the condition that every 3 years thereafter, the amount shall be adjusted to its present value, no, using the Consumer Price Index as published by the Philippine Statistics Authority. Okay? So yung renta naman, no, yung mga rent exempted sa VAT if the monthly rental is does not exceed 15,000 pesos per month. No, monthly rental exempted from payment of value added tax, no, for those leases not exceeding 15,000 per month. Okay, so yun yung provisions natin. Tandaan nyo class, no, yung mga specific rates for, especially for real estate under train law. But by way of summary, under train law natin, uniform na 6%. Capital gain, 6%. Donor's tax, 6%. Estate tax is 6%. Wala na siyang difference, no? Yung tax avoidance na ginagawa ng mga accountants, lawyers, practically minimized na siya under train law. Kasi wala nang distortion, wala nang difference ng rate, pareho lang na 6%. Whether you donate, no, you donate or you sell. Or even if you die, no, 6% pa rin yung estate tax. Act number 11534. Create means Corporate Recovery and Tax Incentives for Enterprises Act. Yung train naman, Tax Reform for Acceleration and Inclusion Law. Create is Corporate Recovery and Tax Incentives for Enterprises Act. So yung CREATE law contains amendments, no, to several provisions of the National Internal Revenue Code of 1997 and focuses also on the reduction of corporate income tax rate and the introduction of new title on tax incentives. So more or less, no, this law favors yung mga corporations or make more specific benefits given to corporations. Tawagan dito corporate recovery, no, and tax incentives for enterprises. So we're presenting here as kuno lang, no, simplified na mga benefits, no, reduction. So before 30% for regular corporate income tax rate. Yung target niyan, yung 30% going 25% or 20%. No, 25% ang 30 ginawang 25%, no, for mga yung general na corporations, but pwedeng going 20% pa rin yan. Subject to the following conditions: if the net taxable income is not more than 5 million ba yan, no, and total assets of not more than 100 million excluding land to which the business entity's office, plant, and equipment are situated, ang benefit mo is 20%. Tapos yung minimum corporate income tax, no, sa previous ng mga laws, 2%, under CREATE law, ginawang 1%. Then additional deductions for labor training expenses dati, no? None, ngayon binigyan niya ng ano to, additional deduction for labor training expenses subject to below conditions. Ano yung nakalagay niya, no? 10%, you're covered by apprenticeship and agreement, supported by DepEd, TESDA, and CHED certification. Before may 10%, yung improperly accumulated earnings, repealed na yan, no? Wala na yan under CREATE law. You have yung proprietary educational institutions and hospitals. Ano to? Di ba may mga eskwelahan tayo ngayon na tinake over ng mga private corporations? So, hindi yung mga non-stock, non-profit na mga eskwelahan, no? Mga religious schools. But you're referring to those schools na inacquire ng mga ano to, ng mga kumpanya. Proprietary educational institutions, no? Their tax, dati kasi 10% of net taxable income. Ngayon, to encourage ano to, these private companies to operate schools, ginawa na lang 1% of the net taxable income. Hindi sila tax exempt kasi they're not religious naman, no? Or charitable. Ginawang, may babayaran sila pero 1% na lang of the net taxable income. The idea is for them to ano to, to enter yung school, no, na mga ginawang school, negosyo na rin siya. But may specific purpose naman yon, no, para to improve yung education in the country. Tapos yung resident foreign corporations, andyan yung difference, no? Before 30%, under CREATE law, ni-reduce to 25%. So, resident foreign corporations, yung minimum corporate income tax, dati 2%, ginawang 1%. That's your table na. No, then you have deductions from gross income, no? Nandito na yung difference. Naka-table na 'yan, andyan na 'yan, almost the same yung kanina. Before none, ngayon meron ng benefits na rin. Dati 30 non-deductible interest expense 33%. There's ni-reduce siya to 20%. So you have also yung regional headquarters, no, ng mga foreign corporations. 10%. But tinaasan siya, no? Effective January 1, 2022 for regional headquarters. Yung ubus, no, yung other na mga those involved by foreign corporations, ni-reduce na siya. Subject to yung gross receipts from 10%, they're subject to yung minimum no na other taxes allowable no for this type of entities. Then you have also yung non-resident foreign corporations before 30%, under CREATE is 25%. So there's a pattern of reduction under CREATE law. The idea is to encourage private businesses. You have also final tax on passive income for unlisted shares. You have yung intercorporate dividends. Ang ibig sabihin ng dito class, no, yung isang corporation, investors sa isang corporation, yung mother corporation magbibigay ng dividendo, no. So you have yung dividends that will be received, no, by the investing corporation subject to dividend tax. intra-corporate dividends under CREATE law, nireduce yan from 15% to 10%. Then value-added tax. Okay, before, may mga requirements, no? Additional requirements under ano to, CREATE law. Before, yung mga mag-import ka ng mga libro, no, mga publications, printing, newspapers, magazines, may 12% under sa CREATE law, exempt siya, no? Exempt siya if certain period of time, no, may exemption. Then you have also ano to, yung sale, importation, prescription, yung mga drugs. Malaki ding tulong to sa karamihan. Dati kasi ang exemption magsimula pa daw January 1, 2023. This year, January, no? Sabi ng CREATE, baguhin natin yan, gawin natin early, no? January 1, 2021. Of course, that benefited also mainly during COVID dahil yung gastos, no, hindi ganun kamahal na kasi VAT exempt siya. As long as it involves yung mga medicines, no, for cancer, mental illness, tuberculosis, and kidney diseases. Percentage tax under CREATE law, before 3%, ngayon 1% na. Okay? Now, dito sa CREATE law, mahaba naman to siya, merong, ang importante dito yung provision about yung, ano to, value, VAT, no, provision under VAT, under CREATE law. So, the previous president, Duterte, vetoed 9 items in the CREATE law na relevant sa practice natin sa real estate. Ano to? Yung proposed increase in the value-added tax or VAT-exempt threshold on the sale of real property up to 4.2 million. Kasi under original na CREATE law as proposed by Congress, they're proposing na ini-exempt yung mga sale of real estate property up to 4.2 million. This was vetoed. Ang bisipin ng veto, presidential veto, may portion ng batas na hindi sumasang-ayon yung presidente natin. Which means that portion of the law will only be affected. The rest of the law will still be implemented. So, CREATE law, napasa pa rin yung CREATE law. Pero vinito ni President Duterte yung ano to, yung VAT exemption na tinaasan. No, ang reason no, ng President, andyan, no, nakalagay dyan, the President believed it is prone to abuse as properties could be parceled into lots so that the individual values fall within the VAT exempted threshold. Okay? Yan yung reason. Sayang naman, no? But ang ginawa ng Department of Finance, okay, in-exempt ni President up to 4.2 million, ang ginawa ng Department of Finance, tinaasan yung exemption by way of regulation. Kasi apparently po ang sponsor ng pagtaas ng VAT exemption, Department of Finance. So VAT exemption ngayon for housing is nasa 3,199,200. Ibig sabihin yung value ng bahay mo, condominium, hindi sumobra sa 3 million, exempt ka sa VAT. More than that, you pay VAT. Ano yung authority? Revenue Regulation Number 8-2021 dated June 11, 2021. Okay, so ayan, no? Covered sa atin yung reason ng Department ng Revenue Regulation Number 8-2021 issued by the Bureau of Internal Revenue under the Department of Finance. No, andyan yung reason kasi before January 1, 2021, yung VAT exemption threshold for sale of house and lot and other residential dwelling, no, was already 3,199,200. Yan na yan eh. So may proposal sila na taasan yan to 4.2 million. Binito nga ng presidente yan. So what happened was, ito may history lang ng amendments yan. No? If you check yung wording ng ano to, yung screenshot natin, ang at the end of yung sinabi dito ng ano to ng Department of Finance, binalik pa rin nila, inadjust pa rin nila yung VAT exemption, no, after it was changed, binalik pa rin nila to 3,199,200 beginning January 1, 2021. Simply pa lang nating discussion, magkano yung VAT exemption ngayon, if that is the question. The VAT exemption for residential lot, no, and other residential dwelling, nasa 3,199,200 pesos. Okay. Again, if you sell beyond this amount, then you are VAT covered. Below, VAT exempted. So ito yung reason ng department order, no? Inflation. No, inflation, consumer price index. For paggawa ng mga adjustments sa values, usually the law authorizes yung administrative body to make adjustments subject to yung changes sa consumer price index. No, definitely in piso next year, this year, hindi naman piso yan. No, if you have inflation of 5%, your piso is 95 centavos. Pareho din dito sa VAT exemption sa housing. No, kasi dati sabi ng Department of Finance eh nasa 3,199,200. Although this was amended, subsequently amended, binalik pa rin nila, ni-reinstate nila. Ang justification is because of ano to, adjustments sa consumer price index. From 2 million in-adjust to, no? Kung tanungin tayo, no, sa board exam, the threshold amount before was 2 million. No, 2 million parang 2021 'yan, no. After more than 10 years, yung 2 million in-adjust yan to 3,199,200, no, in 2011 using the 2010 consumer price index, and this should be upgraded every 3 years thereafter. So pwede na ring baguhin yan after 3 years. Okay?